वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज करंट अफेयर्स फंडा। फ्री एजुकेशन रेवोल्यूशन, डू सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल फॉर मोर अपडेट्स। एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, दैट इज क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस। गाइस, दिस विल बी द पार्ट वन। इन द पार्ट वन बेसिकली वी विल डिस्कस फ्यू थिंग्स, दैट इज कॉन्सेप्ट एंड फ्यू प्रॉब्लम्स। ओके, सो as per the concern of LIC exams, LIC AAO exams and some other banking exams also, so we will deal all of a lots of questions of quadratic equations in this part one. I'll tell you minimum shortest way to simplify the quadratic equations and I'll solve few problems here. And after that, guys, in the part two, this will be very interesting topic. In the part 2, I'll solve SBI PO problems as well as IBPS PO previous year's problems. Okay, so if you have any questions regarding quadratic equations, then you can also post in the comment box. Okay, so guys, let's go. So before going to our channel, first of all, I would like to inform you about our channel. Basically, we are delivering free education for all of you. Spread the word among your friends and share for those people who cannot afford the coaching classes, and you know, learning is priceless, so please do at least for them. That's where they can be benefited from this channel. If you want any specific topic video, then you can comment on our Facebook channel, that is facebook.com/currentaffairsfunda. So friends, if you want us to make a video on a particular topic, then you can post it on our Facebook channel or below this video. So guys, do subscribe this channel. You will be directly notified if I uploaded any new video in this channel. So today is our topic, that is quadratic equations. Okay, so friends, one thing will come definitely in your mind: what is quadratic equations? Okay, see, first one, quadratic equations all are also known as inequalities also. Okay, so the other name of quadratic equations, or we can say this one, is the inequality. Okay, so both are the same name. So I'll discuss each and everything here by one by one. So guys, there is a standard equation. Okay, so we will perform all the operations on the standard equation, that is a x square plus b x plus c barabar 0. That is your quadratic equation, and the root, there will be two roots. X will have two roots. Okay, so you should also know the nature of roots also. Okay, so we will discuss each and everything. So this is the sample of quadratic equation, that is the standard notation. And guys, in this kind of questions, you should aware few things here, that is, you have to given, that is, two equations. One will be in the form of x, that means suppose x square plus 2x plus 4, that is equal to 0. This is equation number 1. And the second equation will be in the terms of y, that is y square plus 2y plus 4, that is equal to 0. These are the basically equation number 1 and equation number 2. So guys, you need to compare the root of each equation. Okay, so you will get, there will be two roots. I don't know whether the roots will be positive or negative, it doesn't matter here, but you should know there will be two roots. In the same way also, for the y case, there will be two roots. Okay, so guys, we need to compare each roots, x with y and x with again this one y, and this x will this one, and this x also this one. Okay, so we need to compare the roots of each element with each other. Okay, so I'll tell you few things here. See, your first option will be x is greater than y. Okay, second case, it will be x is less than y. Third case, it may be x is greater than or equals to by. Fourth case, it may be equals to x is less than or equal to by. And friends, fifth case, that is the case of C and D. If in any case x is not equal to by or there is no relation established, then you can say this case is the cannot determine case, that is C and D case. So basically in the quadratic equations questions, you have these kind of options. Okay, so you should select each among them. Okay, so I will tell you how to compare the roots. Okay, so this is concept one, how to compare the roots, how to compare roots. See, suppose the first value, that is plus 8, and the second value, that is plus 6. Okay, so you can easily say plus 8 is greater than plus 6, then the sign will be here, that is greater than. Okay, and suppose there is a value of, that is minus 2 and minus 3, so then you know very well minus 2 is greater than 3. So dekhiye friends, यहाँ पर हमें क्या करना है, रूट्स को कंपेयर करना है. अगर मैं कहूँ प्लस 8 और प्लस 6, इन दोनों को कंपेयर करेंगे तो कौन सा रूट बड़ा होगा, तो ये प्लस 8 जो है वो ग्रेटर देन है प्लस 6 के, और माइनस 2 है वो ग्रेटर देन है माइनस 3 से. ओके, थर्ड केस इफ गिवन लाइक माइनस 3 एंड देर इज माइनस 2, सो वी कैन से माइनस 3 इज लेस देन माइनस 2. तो दीज आर द कंपेरिजन्स. ओके, सो यू शुड नो दिस इज द सिंबल ऑफ ग्रेटर then and also greater than, and this is lesser than. Okay, and one thing more, kindly note down, this is concept number 2. So guys, this is really very very important concept, and you should write down in your notebook also. Suppose if x square is equal to 25, then there will be two root of x, first will be positive and second will be negative. Okay, so x square is equal to 25, then x will be plus 5 and another x, that will be minus 5. Okay, in the same way, if you have also another equation, that is if x is equal to root 5. Okay, so in such cases x will have only one root, that will be only plus 5. So if you are solving the quadratic equations, then in the x square case there will be two root, first one that is positive, second one that is negative, and in this case x is equal to root 5, so there will be only one root, that is plus 5. And friends, in this case if x cube, that is equal to 125. Okay, so there will be only one root, it will be plus 5. Okay, and there are few things that you should know. We can also write this one thing here. Suppose this is cube root 125 and it will be only plus 5. Okay, so these are the few cases that you should write down in your copy. We will use each of them. And friends, now we will discuss the relations among equations. Okay, suppose your question number 1, this is really very simple example, and you should try this one also. Suppose p cube minus 1652, that is equal to 1092. Okay, and q cube divided by 4, that is equal to 1458, and you have to made a relation among P and Q. What will be the relation here? So first of all friends, solve this one. So you should calculate the value of P cube. So P cube will be 1652, will go another side, it will be positive. So 1652 plus 1092, it will be 2744. Okay, so P, here P will be, you don't need to calculate this one, so you should write this value here, p cube, that is equal to 2744. And guys, you need to calculate the q cube here. Q cube, it will be 4 into 1458, it will be 5832. So guys, why I didn't calculate the value of p cube here? Because p cube, this value is 2744, and q cube, this value is 5832. That means if we compare the value of p cube, that means p cube, that is less than q cube, because this is the power 3 and there is also power 3, then we can easily compare because the power is same. Okay, so p cube is less than q cube, that means p also less than q. Okay, so the relation will be among, will be between p and q, it will be p is less than q. Okay, so this is your answer, and you should choose from the options, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. First one, that is p is less than q. Second is p is greater than q, and p is less than q. P is greater than or equals to q, p is less than or equal to q, and fourth one, that is c and d. So p is less than q, that means your option 2, that is correct one. You should choose this option from the given statement. Okay, I hope you understand this small question. We will solve few more here also. So question number 2, suppose the value of x square, that is 1849, that is given here, and friends, y is equal to, that is in the form of cube root, it is like 79507. Okay, so you need to make a relation between x and y. Okay, so here, that is x square, so the root of x, it will be 1, that is positive, 2nd, that is negative. So if you are calculating this one, then you will get, that is the square root of 43. Okay, so the square of 43, it will equal to 1849. If you don't know how to calculate the squares, then I'll require you to watch a video in the simplification section in our playlist. Okay, so I'll basically give a link inside the description box. Okay, so you should also understand how to calculate the square roots. Okay, so the value of x, it will be plus 43, and the value of x, that is minus 43. Okay, and guys, how you can calculate this cube root? So basically, I have told you in our earlier sessions that how to calculate the cube root. So here, by it will be equal to plus 43. Okay, and now you just need to compare these all the two roots. So guys, this one is the x is equal to plus 43, and this is x is equal to minus 43, and y is equal to plus 43. You can also write one time also, y is equal to plus 43, and you just need to compare this one. So guys, first value will compare with this one and this one also. Okay, and another time, this value with symbol, you should compare with this one and this one also. Okay, so let's do it right now. So plus 43 is equals to equals to, so we can write, that is x is equals to y, and minus 43, that is less than from this statement. Okay, so that is x is less than y. So in the above conclusion, we can say x is less than or equal to y. So this is the relation among these two equations. Okay, I hope you understand this question, and now let's move for the problem number 3, that is here. See, suppose p is to power minus 2, that is equal to 1 divided by 25, and q, that is equals to root 25. Okay, and you just need to establish a relation among p and q. Okay, so p is to power minus 2, that is equal to 1 divided by 25. If you are converting each term, and suppose p is to power 2, convert this one, so it will be 25. okay, so the root of p, it will be 2. First one will be positive, second one will be negative, so it will be plus 5 and another will be minus 5. Okay, and guys, q is equal to root 2 5, that means q will be equal to plus 5 only. Okay, so in the under root case there will be only one root, and in the square case there will be two root, one will be positive and another will be negative. Okay, well, see, so x again, that is 5 for covalencing, and you should compare this one with this one and this one. So plus 5, that is equal to plus 5, so we can say p is equal to q. And guys, in this case minus 5, that is less than from this 5 and this 5, that means we can say p is less than q. Okay, so ultimately we have a conclusion, that is p is less than or equal to q, that is the relation from these two equations. Okay, I hope you understand this one. Now let's discuss few other problems also, that is problem number 4. Suppose the question, that is x is equals to cube root 1 3 3 1, okay, and by square, that is 1 2 1, and you need to establish a relation in between x and y. So x will be plus 1 3 3 1 is the cube root of 11, and in such cases there will be root of by, that will be 2, one will be positive and another will be negative. By square is equal to 1 to 1, that means y will be plus 11 and minus 11. Okay, so you can also write plus 11 here for the covalencing, and you just need to compare the root of x with this one and this one, and you just need to calculate this one with this one and this one. Okay, so this is the basic fundamental. So plus 11, that is equals to this one, so we can say x is equals to y in first case. And if you are comparing plus 11 with minus 11, that means that is greater than y, that means we can also say that is greater than y. And if you are comparing this one, plus 11, that is equals to y, that means we have already written here plus 11, that is greater than minus 11, that means from these two statements we can conclude that x is greater than or equals to y. So this is our answer. I hope you have done a lots of practice in this case. Okay, so friends, solve one more problem here. Suppose your options like first, second, third, fourth and fifth. First, that is x is greater than y. Second is x is greater than or equals to y. Third is x is less than y. Fourth one, x is less than or equal to y. And fifth one, that is x is equals to y or x is not equals to y or c and d. If these four options are not coming from your answer, coming from in your answer, then you can say the five option, that is correct. Okay, so see, your question is here. Suppose x is equals to cube root here, that is 3 5 7 9 11, okay, and y is equals to under root 5 0 4 1. Okay, so guys, by default here will be 2, and if 3 is not given here, then you can consider as a under root. If 3 is given, that means this is cube root. Okay, so this is the way to judge whether the cube root is here or square root is here. Okay, so if you solve this one, then this will be plus. So if you don't know how to calculate the cube root or square root with the help of short trick, then you should watch our video in our simplification folder, which is already available in the playlist, and I will also give a link below the definition, below the definition in the part, okay, in the definition section, I'll give you that link here, okay. So guys, if you calculate this one, then this is the cube root of 7 1, okay. And if you calculate this one, then you will get y that is equal to plus 7 1, okay. So you don't need, you just need to compare this x with this y only, because there are both the values are positive. You don't need to copy another positive value here and another positive value here, and you don't need to compare all these one. So you can easily say x is equals to y, okay. So this is your relation here. So guys, in the options, this one not, this one also not, this one also not matching with our answer, this one also. So this is the CND case that is here, okay. So it's all about the quadratic equations, and we will solve some tougher problems also here. See friends, suppose our question, one more problem here also. Suppose x square that is equal to 7 to 9, okay, and y cube that is 1 3 3 1, okay. So you just need to compare with x is to y, so there will be the root of x, it will be 2, 1 will be positive and another will be negative. So 729, this is the square of 27 and negative 27, and y cube is equal to 1 3 3 1, okay. So it will be y is equal to plus 11, okay. So we can also say plus 1 here for the co-balancing. And first of all, we will compare this root with first times y and another times y. So plus 27, that is greater than y and greater than also y, so we can say that is greater than y. And in this case friends, x is equal to minus 27, that is lesser than y and also lesser than y, then we can say that is lesser than y. So from this we cannot say x is whether greater than or equals to y, less than or equals to y, or only greater than y. That means no relation here, okay. So this will be the case of cannot determine, that is option number 5, okay. Friends, option number 5 always will not be the option number 5, that is CND case. You should read the carefully statement first of all you should read the statement very very carefully, and after that you can judge whether the option, which one option is related to your conclusion part, okay. So I hope you understand these basic simple problems here. And guys, so we will basically discuss the factor method, how we can factor a quadratic equation, okay. So basically, suppose your equation that is here, so this one general concept, suppose your equation that is x square plus 2x plus 9 that is equal to 0. Suppose this one is a sample equation here, okay. So I am just telling you what is the root of x. There will be 2 root of x, okay. So we can also say that is negative plus positive sign, and here that is also positive sign, okay. So the root of x will be what in this case. So I will make a table, I am preparing a table for you, and you have to read that table, okay. So root table symbols, okay. See, suppose there is a standard equation that is x square plus ax plus b that is equal to 0. So the sign of a, and the second option will be sine of b, and nature of first root and second, nature of second root here, okay. So I will tell you here. Okay, suppose the sign of A first time negative and sign of B that is also negative. Okay, so your first root that will be positive and second root that will be negative. Okay, if your sign of A that is negative, if your sign of B that is positive, then both the nature of root of first element it will be positive and for the second that will also be positive. And in this case, if first one is positive, second one is negative, then the nature of root it will be opposite, that is minus, and it will be plus. And guys, if both the roots are that is plus, A sign that is plus and B sign that is plus, then you will get the nature of root of first that is negative and second one that is negative also. Okay, so this is the basic fundamental table that you should learn. And guys, there is also a alternate to avoid this table. So we will solve a quadratic equations question on the two base. First of all, I will tell you how to solve this equation and compare this equation on the basis of these symbols, and after I will tell you a direct method also. Okay, so you should write down this table also. Okay, we will use this table. So friends, suppose our first question, that is p square plus 11p plus 30, that is equal to 0, and second one, that is q square minus 11q plus 30, that is equal to 0. Okay, so in this case the root of p it will be, first will be positive, second will be negative, and in this case also the root of q that is equal to plus and negative. Okay, see, that is 30 here. So if you factorize this 30, then you will get 6 and 5. So 6 into 5 that will be 30, and if you are adding this one, 6 plus 5 it will be 11. Okay, so the perfect root of 30 that will be 6 and 5. Okay, and friends, in this case we can also say this one is called to 6 and 5. So if you are multiplying 6 and 5, then you will get 30, and if you are the symbol that is minus 6 and minus 5, then minus 6 and minus 5 it will be minus 11, and if you are multiplying this one, minus 6 into minus 5 minus 5, it will be plus 30. Okay, so these are the basically factors method. Okay, so the first root, if this one is here, if this one the symbol that is plus and plus here, and this one is minus here, and this one is plus here. If first root is plus and second root is also plus, then the value of p it will be negative, then the root of first that will be negative and root of second that will also be negative. Okay, you can tally this one from our previous table that I made for you. We can also write here for you if you want. Okay, so we are summarizing here, minus minus, then you will get plus minus, and if that is minus plus, then you will get plus plus. Okay, if that is plus and minus, then you will get minus plus. If you are getting the root of plus plus, then the nature of root it will be minus minus. So guys, in this case that is plus and plus, so this is the case of last one, so the root, the nature root that it will be negative negative. Okay, so in this case minus plus, so minus plus is here, there will be both plus plus. Okay, so we can write 6 and 5 here, and also the root of q it will be, if that is minus and plus, so in the case of minus plus both root it will be plus plus. Okay, so it will be plus 6 and plus 5. Okay, so we can easily say here, that is p पी इज लेस देन क्यू बिकॉज माइनस सिक्स इज लेसर देन माइनस प्लस सिक्स एंड माइनस फाइव ऑल्सो लेसर देन प्लस सिक्स एंड प्लस फाइव सो वी कैन इजली से पी इज लेस देन क्यू सो दिस इज द रिलेशन दैट आर कमिंग फ्रॉम दीज टू इक्वेशंस ओके आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस प्रॉब्लम हेयर एंड नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस फ्यू मोर प्रॉब्लम्स हेयर सपोज there's a question like p square minus 5p plus 6 that is equal to 0 okay and q square minus 3q plus 2 that is also equal to 0 okay so guys how you can directly calculate this problem okay so I will solve this equation without help of that table okay so the root of 6 that is 3 into 2 3 and 2 and the root of 2 the factors of 2 it will be 2 and 1 if you are multiplying this one 2 into 1 you will get 2 and the factor of 6 that it will be equal to 3 into 2 if you are multiplying this one 3 into 2 you will get directly 6 okay so minus 3 and minus 2 minus 3 and minus 2 if you are adding these two element then you will get the minus 5 and if you are multiplying this one minus 3 into minus 2 it will be plus 6 okay so friends you should read this question very carefully because this trick is really very technical see plus 6 how you can factor of how you can factorize plus 6 that is minus 3 into 2 okay only 3 into 2 you will get 6 but how you can made minus 5 so minus 3 and minus 2 minus 3 and minus 2 it will be minus 5 and if you are multiplying minus 3 with minus 2 then you will get plus 6 okay so what will be the root of p if both the symbols are negative then you can say this one will be positive okay you just need to reverse the symbols so minus 3 and minus 2 so minus will be plus and this minus will be plus so it will be 3 it will be 2 here I hope you understand this part and now apply the same trick here 2 into 1 that you will get 2 but how to establish this minus 3 so we can say minus 2 and minus 1 so if you are multiplying this minus 2 with minus 1 then you will get plus 2 and if you are adding minus 2 and minus 1 then you will get the minus 3 okay so the root of q that will be 2 and 1 again reverse their symbols that is minus so you will get plus this one is minus also so you will get plus 1 here okay so friends you can easily compare this one so plus 3 that is greater than this one and this one also so we can say p is greater than q and now you need to compare the second line here p is plus 2 so plus 2 that is equals to q so we can say p is equal to q and you need to compare plus 2 from this one also plus 2 is greater than plus 1 so we have already written here so from these two conclusions we can say p is greater than or equals to q okay friends so friends you have seen here in such cases we have not used the concept of table okay so if you know the table then you can easily find the root of find the nature roots here also okay so I hope you understand this question so I think I need to make another example here suppose there is a problem like x square minus 4x no x square minus x minus 12 that is equal to 0 and another part that is y square plus 7y plus 12 that is equal to 0 okay so you just need to compare these two from here so guys first of all we have to find the root of x that will be 2 one will be whatever or both will be the positive or both will be negative or one will be positive one will be negative we don't know okay so how to calculate so first of all the factor of 12 So factor of 12, that will be 4 and 3. So if you are multiplying this one 4 into 3, you will get 12. And if you are performing operations on 4 and 3, then you can easily get the minus 1 here. So friends, see, minus 4 and plus 3. Okay. If you are multiplying these two elements, minus 4 into minus into plus 3, minus 4 into plus 3, you will get easily minus 12. And minus 4 plus 3, that means minus 1 from here. So these are the perfect roots. So the value of x, it will be 4 and 3, and just need to reverse the symbols. So this is minus, so it will be plus, and this is plus, so it will be minus here. Okay, so these are the two roots without seeing our table. We can directly find out. And the friends, 12, that is also 4 and 3. If you are multiplying this one 4 into 3, you will get 12. And if you are adding plus 4 plus 3, okay, so plus 4 plus 3, that is plus 7, and plus 4 into plus 3, that is 12. So these are the perfect roots. So the root of by, it will be 4 and 3. Okay, so the symbol that is here plus, and that is also here plus, so you need to reverse these two symbols, then you will get minus here and minus here. Okay, and friends, you just need to compare these two roots. X is to the by, so plus 4, this one is greater than this one and also greater than this one, so we can say x is greater than y. Okay, and you just need to compare this one, minus 3, that is greater than this one, what equals to this one. Greater than this one, that is also written here, equals to this one, that is x is equals to y. Okay, so from these two conclusions we can say easily x is greater than or equals to y. So this is the best method to solve such kind of problems. Okay, so friends, this is request to you, kindly solve as much as problems on the same method, and you will get definitely the perfect solution with this help. If you are unable to solve such kind of problems from this method, then you can either pick the table method. Okay, so basically I have cleared both the one. And friends, there are few tricks, then you can directly calculate the relation among two equations without solving the equations. Okay, so these are the two tricks made by me. This is my speculation, and this performs 100% true. Okay, so you should write down this one also. So first one, that is, if you have a equation like x square plus bx minus c is equal to 0 here, and your another equation, that is y square plus cx minus d, that is equal to 0 here. Okay, so what will be the relation among x is to y? Okay, so friends, if the value of c, that is negative, and the value of d, that is also negative. Okay, if that is given in your equations, then in such kind of questions, the answer will be C and D in all ways. Okay, so you can directly calculate without solving the equations. Okay, whatever the equations, it doesn't matter what your answer will be. C and D cannot determine. Suppose example, I am just taking this example. Okay, see, suppose 3x square plus 14x minus 93 is equals to 0, and such cases 7y square plus 28y minus 108, that is equal to 0. And you just need to tell to the examiner that what will be the relation in between x and y. So that is negative here, that is negative here, so we can calculate from here, that is the case of C and D. Okay, without solving the equation, you can apply this method in any question. Pick up the previous year papers, just apply the same method, you will get the result that is CND, cannot determine. Okay, and guys, another trick from this trick developed by me, because I have solved a lots of problems, so I have made some speculations and I am just giving to you only. Suppose the value of x that is positive and another value of x that is negative. Okay, and in this case the value of y that is positive or the value of y that is negative, or the value of x that is negative and the value of x that is positive. Okay, and if the value of y that is negative or the value of y that is positive. Okay, so in such cases you don't need to compare this one. Okay, your answer will be always C and D. So these are the two cases that I have derived for you. Okay, you can apply this method in any question. If you are getting the root of x, one is positive, another one is negative, and if the root of y, that is one is positive and another one is negative, then you can directly find out from here. This will be the case of cannot be determined. Okay, so these are the two cases. And friends, there are certain examples also. So how to calculate few square roots also. So these are some tougher problems here. So I will solve this one also here. Suppose your question will be like this: if 2x square minus 11x plus 12 is equal to 0, and second equation, that is 2y square minus 17y plus 36, that is equals to 0. Okay, so how you will tackle this problem, because there is a prefix, that is 2 here, and there is also 2 here. Okay, so first of all you have to multiply this 2 with this one. Okay, 12 into 2, that is 24. Okay, so you just need to factorize the 24 in the same way that you will get this element here. So 24 factor, that it will be 8 is to 3. Okay, so 8 into 3, that is 24, and minus 8 minus 3, minus 8 minus 3, it will be minus 11, and if you are multiplying this one, minus 8 into minus 3, you will get plus 24. Okay, so the value of x, it will be 8 and another will be 3. So convert the symbol here, reverse the symbol, that is minus, so it will be plus. If that is minus, then it will be plus. Okay, so in the same way you should multiply this 2 with 36. Okay, you don't need to multiply this one. Suppose 2 into 36 here. Okay, so we can say, friends, 2 into 36, that is like 4 into 9 here. Okay, 4 into 9, that is 36, and 2 will be same. Okay, so if you are making pair of 2 into 4, that is 8 and 9. Okay, so if you are multiplying this one, minus 8 into minus 9. Okay, so minus 8 into minus 9, it will be plus 36, plus 72, it will be this one. Okay, minus 8 into 9, minus 9, it will be plus 72. If you are adding this one, minus 8 is to minus 9, then it will be minus 17. Okay, so from here you can find out the root of y. It will be 8 and 9. Reverse the symbol. This is minus, then this will be plus. This is minus, then this will be plus. Okay, so you just need to compare again. This one will compare this one first time. So plus 8 plus 8, that is x is equal to y. If you are comparing this one with this one, that is x is less than y. Okay, so plus 3, that is less than from this one. This is plus 3, also less than from this one. Less than also written here. So from these two conclusions we can finalize the conclusion, that is x is less than or equals to y. Okay, so this is the perfect and right answer here. Okay, so in such type of problems you should try this one. Okay, and guys, after this session don't forget to watch our part 2. Okay, so basically in the part 2 section I will solve some tedious problems of IBPS PO previous years, as well as SBI PO and associate previous years PO problems. Okay, so basically in the part 2 section I will solve some sets of 5 question live for you. They will be much lengthier. Okay, so you should watch that video also. Okay, I hope you understand the basic fundamental of quadratic equations from this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe this channel. And friends, this is Current Affairs Funda. Do like here, do comment and do share. If you have any query regarding anything, then you can comment below this video. And if you have any suggestions regarding anything, then you can also email us, or email ID that is currentaffairsfunda@gmail.com. okay, so this is our email ID. So friends, do subscribe. If you didn't subscribe this channel, can you do subscribe, because you will be directly notified from this channel if I uploaded any new video here. Okay, so I hope you have understand all the basic fundamental of quadratic equations. And guys, don't forget to watch the part 2. I will upload the part 2 within days. Okay, thanks guys for watching this video. Have a nice day.